introduce you to Stanley, the sick watermelon. He's not feeling so great. Not looking so hot. So we're gonna make him puke using some potassium iodide and hydrogen peroxide and soap. We've got this 125 milliliter flask, and we are going to start by mixing in the soap, about 5 milliliters. So it's gonna be like this, this.
Oh.
A little more.
There you go.
Like that. Okay. And then we're going to mix in 10 grams of potassium iodide, which is right here. I've measured it already. I'm gonna get that in there like that. Oh boy. Now what you could do is use food coloring and make this fun colored. We're not gonna do that because we just don't want to. We're gonna place this in here. Now what's gonna happen, so what this foam is going to do is shoot out, except not that bad. It's just going to make him look like he's puking. So that's 50 milliliters of hydrogen peroxide, and I'm going to pour this in here, put the top on here, and run away. Oh geez, that didn't work at all. That was terrible. I didn't get that on.
No, you didn't get it.
It didn't work. You can see. Stanley exploded. This is not a good thing. This is not how this experiment is supposed to go. But don't anyone touch that, because that is super hot. It will burn you. It will also see you. Okay. So the first try didn't work so well. We're going to lower our measurements here by half. So because this is... this experiment was meant for a large pumpkin or a large watermelon. We have a small watermelon. If we use the regular amount of things, it will shoot into the camera, and I don't want my cameraman to be scalded for life. We like him without scars, so. And make sure that when you're doing this, you have a garbage bag laid out underneath, because it will stain floors and burn you. So use safety gear, lab coat, gloves, eyeglasses.